Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from Guy in the Cube. And have you ever had your database administrator come up to you and go, hey, can you stop sending all those left outer joins to my database? And you go, I don't know if I can. Well, in this video, I'm gonna show you. Stay tuned. If you find this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam and this guy. When you're using DirectQuery, Power BI can be a little chatty. It can be a little chatty and send some queries back to the database. And you gotta be really careful. And if you have a watchful DBA like I used to do, DBA is watching those queries come through and probably like, why is he always sending left outer joins? My data is good. You don't need to do a left outer join. You can do inner join and you'll get the right data, right? You'll get valid data. You'll get valid results. Storage mode is really important for this. And I'm gonna show you the different combinations of storage modes that this will work with. So you guys know I like to do, instead of all this talking, let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. So I've created this model. The new model view, you can quickly tell that these are in direct query mode. This is dual mode, and this is an import table. And so if I went over here, and this is just a very raw model. So if I said, let's do this. If I go currency name, and I use my implicit measures that are out there, and let me go over here and use internet sales, and just choose one of these implicit measures. Right? All I want you to see is what'll happen with the query. So if I do this, Power BI is gonna take some time because it's in direct query mode. I'm gonna go view, and then what I'm gonna do is turn on performance analyzer, start recording and refresh because I wanna capture that query. In the meantime, while that's going, I'm gonna go ahead and open up DAX Studio because I want you to take a peek at this query. Okay, so I'm gonna copy this. And what I'm gonna do is paste that in there. And then you can see at the top, there's some queries, right? Some DAX queries. But what I'm really concerned about is this SQL query. And you can see left outer join that is sending between my internet sales table and my currency table, because that's the two tables used in to visualize that element. Well, how do I stop that? Well, it's actually really easy. All you need to do is go over to the relationship view, double click on the relationship or edit the relationship, and you're gonna see an option right here, assume referential integrity. And you can, you know, click this link to go learn more about it. But if you just check it, it's gonna do some validation for us. Wait for it to validate, click okay. If I came back over here now, I clear all this out, refresh my visual, wait for it to run the query, go grab it, head over to DAX Studio and paste it in, and now you see an inner join. Perfect, now my DBA is happy. You gotta be careful with this because there's different combinations of storage mode that you need to understand when you can set this and when you can't. Let me show you. If you head back over to Power BI Desktop and go into the model view, you can see these two are in direct query mode. And if I go to edit relationships again, you'll see that my referential integrity is enabled and I can check it. What about a table in direct query in dual mode? Let's see if that, what'll happen there. So go double click. Yeah. So if you have one table in direct query and one in dual mode, you can set referential integrity. So we'll skip the validation. What if both tables are in dual mode? Kind of doesn't make any sense because if they're both import, it's probably going to hit the cache anyway, but let's check to see if we can do it. Yep. I can do it there also. Okay. Now, what happens when I introduce import? Well, there's a whole bunch of things that happens under the covers. And so if I double click here between an import and a direct query table, can't do it. Because the table is import, it's completely cached, so I can't generate SQL to query that cached table because Power BI is gonna try to hit the cache. Same thing, right? If I use an import table and a table in dual mode, this is probably gonna hit the cache anyway because both of them have an aspect of import in it. And like you guessed, no assume referential integrity. And so these limited relationships, I talked about them in another video. There's some documentation you should go read on those. Just with one checkbox, you can make your DBA happy. And if you're using direct query, a combination of direct query, a combination of dual and direct query, you can force inner joins back to your source. Okay, I'd love to know if you guys ever encountered this. Have you face your DBA and try to figure that out? Have you checked this box before? Do you have any questions, comments? You guys know what to do. Let's continue the conversation where? In the comments below. If it's your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button. If you like my video, give me a big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.